topic for candidates on the ballot for upcoming elections and campaigns, they're getting more intense.
Television ads all over the place, they play a big role for candidates to get their messages out to voters, but some methods can be controversial. Here's tonight's Point of View with Otis Sanford.
Political ads, for better or for worse, are a constant staple in an election year. Heavily contested campaigns are good financially for local TV stations, even if viewers get weary of the barrage of ads. The Tennessee governor's race on the Republican side is now an extremely tight contest, and the result is negative advertising, particularly with the top two candidates, Diane Black and Randy Boyd. A political action committee supporting Boyd and Boyd himself fired the first attacks by accusing Congresswoman Black, a former state lawmaker, of voting to give driver's licenses to illegal immigrants and refusing to fund President Trump's border wall. As the race began to tighten, Black responded with negative ads of her own against Boyd and GOP hopeful Bill Lee, accusing them of being moderates. Recently, Black's campaign sent out flyers to individual households with a photo of someone posing as Boyd, looking in a mirror and seeing a reflection of former President Obama. The caption reads, "Randy Boyd does not reflect our conservative values." And the flyer is clearly aimed at conservative voters who dislike Obama for whatever reason. Most political pundits say negative ads work, and perhaps they do. But some, as in the anti-Obama brochure, are utterly distasteful and reflect the worst in the political process. Yes, the stakes are high this election season, particularly in the governor's race. So expect the negative ads to continue. And that's my point of view. I'm Otis Sanford for Local 24 News.